Welcome to Customizing BricsCAD. My name is Ralph Grabowski, and it's my pleasure to show you how to make BricsCAD work the way you work. Transparency is a property that lets you fade objects. Here I've got the word BricsCAD, and I'm going to come over here to the Properties palette and change the transparency. When you select 90, that is the most transparent an object can be. I'm going to select it now, and you can see how it just fades away. There are other levels too, so for example, 40 isn't quite as faded. Another way to change transparency is through the Layers command. Now in this dialog box, you can see that there is a column for transparency, and I'm going to change the layer on which I have the word BricsCAD transparency from 0, which means completely opaque, no transparency, to 90. And then close the dialog box, but look, the transparency has not changed. And that's because the transparency I set over here in the Properties palette overrides it. To have the Layers control transparency, I need to change this back to by layer. And now I can go into the layer dialog box again, change the transparency to 90, and there we go. BricsCAD allows you to control the transparency of hatch patterns and solid fill areas, both of which of course are created by the hatch command, separately from all other entities. You can assign a separate transparency for every hatch pattern, so let's take a look at how that works. I'm going to enter in the hatch command. There's the dialog box. I'm going to fill an area with the hatch and click OK. And there we have the rather prominent hatch pattern there. Now we can click the hatch pattern and change the transparency over here in the Properties dialog box. And I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to bring it down to 90. And there you go. The other way to, of course, control hatches is to double-click them. Then you can specify the transparency. Interestingly enough, whereas for regular entities, you can only set transparency in increments of 10, i.e. 10, 20, 30, 40. In hatch patterns, you can actually go to the nearest unit, 71 if you want. And I'm going to say go down to here, 49, click OK, and it is a bit darker, but not as dark as the original. Transparency is controlled separately in the plotting process. Let me bring up the plot dialog box here, and you can see that there is a toggle whether or not you want to plot transparency. The reason it's a toggle, the reason you can turn transparency on or off for plotting purposes, is because some plotters can't handle transparency. They can't actually simulate the look-through nature of transparent objects. So if your plotter can handle it, great, have this on, and if you want to see it, otherwise leave it turned off. When you click the preview button, then you'll actually get to see the transparency in the preview. Click print to find out whether or not your printer handles transparency. Now BricsCAD does have a transparency command, but it doesn't do what you think it would do. It actually affects the transparency of the backgrounds of images attached to the current drawing, so nothing to do with see-throughness of all other entities in the drawing. If you want to change the transparency of the command line, say through a script file or just because you prefer typing things, then you'll need to enter in the Seee Transparency command and then change the value, such as to 90, and that sets the current value of transparency for all items to be created from now on until you change the value again. And then there is a separate variable for handling the transparency of hatch patterns, and its name is HP Transparency. I should mention there is a fourth type of transparency in BricsCAD. In addition to transparency for entities, transparency for hatch patterns, a form of transparency for images, and that is fade control. And you can see I have here an XREF inserted in the drawing and it looks faded. Why is that? Well, let's go into settings and hunt for fade. And we can see that there's three system variables that control fading. One is for locked layers. That's right. If a layer is locked, you can tell it to be, well, transparent, but here it's called faded. If you have an XREF, you can again make it faded, and there the value is 70, so that's quite a bit more faded than a locked layer. And finally, reference editing. That's if you double click an XREF or a block and you're editing it within the rough editor, then you can have the non-edited portions be faded out. And that's what this setting is for. I trust you enjoyed learning how to make BricsCAD work the way you work. For more on customizing BricsCAD, check out the ebook.
Download the free trial version of BricsCAD at www.bricsys.com and check it out for yourself.